know, it's so hard because I, like, when I work, I just add in colors, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, you just grab whatever. You've got a good eye for, you know, where you're going, and it's just kind of instinctive.
Yeah.
Whereas me, I'm trying to learn all this stuff. So that's the thing I've noticed about a lot of the, like, really high-level painters that really enter Crystal Brush and win all the time in their categories is they've been doing it for so long. When they try to teach novices, there are so many steps between a novice and where they are. It's really hard for them to translate, really.
Yeah.
Oh, what's this color?
Let's see. This is... she's more like... She's got... Oh, let me go find my... Okay, so I've got this, I've also got this skin tone, it's skin tone base. It's almost, I think it almost might be like that color that you have.
The golden skin?
Yeah, the golden skin.
Because I have basic flesh, which is, but the problem is it's like really, like you can see the difference between the two. It's like a lot darker.
Well, this one's lighter than... But you can kind of see on the top here.
It's even lighter. Well, I got another shade beyond that. That it seems with the scale color paints. I wish I could show you the thing, but they're like literally glued to my desk. The whole set of them. They like you can see the scale. These are three colors away.
Oh yeah.
And they progress really nicely. So.
So and I've also got. I told you the light yellow, the Naples hue, so it's a light color. And then I put some paper towel underneath my palette, so it reads more white than yellow. So it might be a little easier. So I've got that. So those we can go with those colors. We can make it easier.
Okay, I've got a nice light yellow too. It's like almost a pastel. Yeah.
Okay.
Is that what I can? Because I can barely see the top of that bottle. Is it clear on the top?
This one?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's like it's almost like a pastel color.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I've got a.
It's a light yellow. Yeah.
Okay. I think I've got something for that then. Okay.
And that should be basically. I have this darker like burgundy wine color, which is a dark red.
Okay.
I also have. Like a model color this is black red. It's Vallejo.
Trying to think if I have that one, but if I do, it's way in the basement. So like a burgundy red.
You can improvise. I mean, it's not.
Yeah, they're not going to match exactly. I'm more learning technique on this than anything, so.
That's
too deep. Alright, I got another one that's more of a red, too. Okay. Fortunately, with this set of paints, I've got a lot to choose from, so I should be fine. I just want to make sure that they're all out, so we're not trying to figure out when I start. We've got time, so.
And I didn't know if I should, I'm trying to adjust my camera a little more. I didn't know if it was okay. I have a hairdryer. Because when I do the base coats, I usually, to speed it up, I'll use a hairdryer.
I have a heat gun, so it's the same thing, but I'll have to hold it further away.
Okay. But I was like, oh, well, we're on a stream. I'm like, I don't know. I know, like, when you're on a Google Hangouts, it automatically mutes things, but I usually do it while doing it low, so.
Okay. No, it's good. I just, like I said, I just gotta hold mine further away. So...
So you don't melt your model.
Yep. No, I was doing that. I was doing that from yesterday. Well, I was trying to do the whatchamacallit. Dang it, what was I saying? My brain just turned off. I was trying to put water effects on the base of one of my Flower Witch models. But I was impatient and I wanted to at least get the top to set to harden a little bit. But of course I'm an idiot and I forgot it's resin, so I used the heat gun and then she started tilting.
Oh no.
because her little legs or the ankles are so thin compared to her torso, she just started toppling. It's like, nope, I'm done. Nope. Put it in front of a fan or something?
Yeah. Well, no, not in front of a fan. You just, like, you blow on it lightly, like, with your mouth a little bit, and the bubbles should come out. And then what I do to keep, because I have animals,
right.
So what I do to keep the light to then grab out is I just cover it with a Tupperware container. Like, I set it on my table where I know nobody's going to mess with it, and I just put a Tupperware container over it.
That makes sense. So, right, but it's still settling, so it smooths out those bumps from your finger. Yep.
And I'm like, oh, thank God, now I at least learned.
No, I made the mistake. Well, part of my problem is I don't have a nice wall around the miniature, so I tried wrapping it in tape, and I just couldn't create a good enough seal.
Yeah.
So I gave up. I've got another way without using Water Effects to provide water texture. So I'll be doing that, but. I'm going to end up getting some Secret Weapon has, like, hollow bases, so they've got a built-in
yes.
lip around them, and I'll use that instead. It's a lot easier.
Yeah, that is easier, because, like, if you want to do the water effects, you have to hot glue the plastic to the base, and then you have to take it off afterwards, and it's such a pain. And...
Yeah, and I'm OCD about giving it a nice round edge.
Yeah.
And hot glue, it's just so, you really can't do that. Not 100% anyway.
Well, you buff it off with fine thread sandpaper, but it's still a chore, and you have to be very careful with it, so it's just a pain.
Yep.
But, yeah, it is a lot of work, so. And there are other ways. I know, like, the Woodland Scenics makes a water effect that you can pour in really thin layers.
Cool.
That isn't as much of a pain as the. I'm sure it's resin, but it's not a two-part resin. It's already mixed, right? So.
Oh, nice.
Just air hardens. You can get it at Hobby Lobby. So.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out how to mix it with resin with like dyes and paints because I want to do for my space walls. I want to do it so they actually look like cracked glaciers.
Yeah.
But I've got to figure out how to sculpt them first, and then figure out the resin. Because I want them to look organic, but that's going to be a chore. I might have to, like, 3D design them and 3D print them.
Well, they have, like, the Micro Arts Bases has the frozen ones, don't they?
Yeah, but they're like, frozen tundra. I need, like, actual, like, cracked glaciers. Like if a ship were going through the Arctic and, you know, all the ice break up and stuff.
Honestly, look at some of Wobble's. Wobble has, like, some of his older tutorials on there. I think at one point he made glaciers, or he did lava or something, which you could probably try to do the same thing, but just with different colors.
Okay.
But I think Wobble's got some older basic tutorials, so.
Cool.
Because he did a lot of those Micro Arts Bases for Full Mini, like, a lot of those were designed, or he painted them at least, so.
Yeah. Makes sense. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, do we want to? We can at least do like a base coat, so we're not waiting.
Yeah, I didn't know if the base coat, like, if you were good with that.
Yeah, I mean, we've got 10 minutes until the stream starts, so we can do a base coat. It's fine.
Okay, and then what I should do is I should restart the stream. I should turn off my camera and turn it back on.
No, so you've got the maximum amount of time.
Yeah, the safety feature usually it's about 30 minutes, but I just like I said.
Oh, okay. Well, I lost Skype anyway for some reason. Like, it's still there, but it's not. Like, the window just died on me. And...
Yeah,
So I gotta redo that anyway.
It's probably hiding.
No, it for some reason, the window's still there, but in my broadcaster software, the window literally snapped to be, like, a couple pixels tall, so I just see this little bar. Oh, there we go. Skype. Okay. Oh, no wonder it looked bad. I chose the wrong window in the first place. I chose the current call one, which is really tiny.
So it pixelates everything.
Yeah, it extremely pixelated everything. All right.
Okay, I have to show you my calendar too.
Make sure that I've got it centered around the mini in the window here. I might have to make the window a little off-center, but...
That's fine.
Yeah.
And I'll try to keep it conscious of, like, I try to keep it within the space here, so...
Yeah, I've got it from kind of where, the top of your paint, what is it called? Paint tube on your, next to your right hand, and then the very top of the window is... Kind of at the bottom of where you're, like, the top corner of your palette.
Is that better?
No, it's fine. I'm just telling you what the window is.
Okay.
So you kind of have an idea. So you're fine. Don't worry about it too much. As long as I can see, I'm going to kind of replicate what you're doing anyway, so.
Okay.
So what are we starting with?
I turn off one of my lights because I think it makes it less bright for you.
It looked better when that light was turned off.
This light is turned off, and then I turned on. I have two lights on. But if I turn this one on, it's really bright. But it kind of helps the color a little bit.
Okay.
But I have to have the lights on or I can't paint.
Right. Exactly.
So, I'm gonna take that, I have that pink color, this one.
Okay.
Rosy skin,
okay.
And I'm gonna mix a little bit, I'm gonna make a base tone.
Okay.
So just kind of like between the two.
And then what are the other two colors you're mixing?
So that's just, these are the two colors, the black and brown is this one, and then this is burgundy wine.
Okay.
So this is actually... more red.
Okay.
I think I'm going to do that as my shadows.
Sorry, yeah, we didn't go over the black and brown, so I'm trying to find a color that's similar.
It's a warm brown. It's a warm, dark brown.
Alright, I got one. Cool.
Then I'm just going to do a base coat.
I have a separate camera for my palette so people can see what I'm mixing. And I always try to maximize my palette space, so sometimes it's not in frame, which is weird. So I like starting on a small corner and it's never in frame. So I can really see the color you're using, so it should be pretty easy to mix.
And if I'm not
Okay. I don't know why I'm here. So in about a couple minutes, I'll start streaming, Lucina.
Okay.
I just want you to be prepped. I won't, normally I worry about chat and stuff, but for this, I want to maximize, you know, the time, so I'm not going to worry about that.
People are pretty chill, right? I mean...
Yeah, no, they'll just ask a bunch of questions and I won't respond to them, so... lighter than yours. It makes more.
Yeah, we got a little bit more darker.
Yeah. Pretty much a lot darker, actually. It looks the same on my palette as it does on yours, but when I put on the model, it looked a lot lighter.
It also might be because it's just the variation in the light, too.
And then we'll dry
and then
darker. Yeah, I usually put up the art card when I'm working on Mini, on just on screen so that I can see and everybody can see what I'm going for. But I didn't do that this time because I'm going off of what you're doing, so. Yeah, the hardest part about streaming is just keeping my fingers out of frame. So we're gonna do those, so I'm pinning the leg too? Yeah, okay. Because
yeah,
we're gonna...
Paint. So what you're gonna wanna do is you don't have to paint the whole leg.
Oh, okay.
So right here with the sheer cloth, where it's gonna show through mostly, is here, and then here on your leg. So I don't...
Oh, I gotcha. So that's more for later than for now.
Yeah, I'm gonna work up to my skin tone, but only in this small area. And I'll show you what I mean.
Right, because you're gonna darken up everything else. You don't really need to worry too much.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
I'm just making sure I have even base coats on. All right, let me turn off the camera and turn it back on.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and it'll do that. You'll hear it make that noise. And I have to let it sit.
It's fine. I see the awesome logo in the middle of your screen, and that's it.
Yeah. It's pretty funny.
It's okay. I'm painting everything while I'm waiting, so it's all good. Alright, if I start streaming?
Yeah, that's fine.
Cool. Mine are too. I'm just trying to make sure. I have this. I'm really impatient when I do my base coats, so I'm never patient enough to where I let it completely dry, and I need to kick myself every time I do that, because then it pulls up the paint for no reason.
Yeah. I mean, it's warm here. I know you're further north than I am, so it's probably still fairly cold there.
Yeah, it's not too warm. It was nice, though.
Here it's in the mid-70s, so...
Yeah, we're not nearly that warm.
Well, I got cold yesterday, and it's supposed to be cold tomorrow, so it's supposed to rain, so... Alright, so... What I'm gonna do, so I can show you my palette again, and let me know if I'm going too fast.
Alright, yeah, I'm just... I will kind of watch you as I'm still base coating.
So. Alright, sounds good. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put in some shadows.
Okay.
And what I always tell everybody, I taught a skin tones class and at Adepticon, and I was like, you know, it's always this process of going back and forth between everything and adding in your shadows and adding in your highlights. So when I put down shadows, it's not that I'm done putting down shadows, because if I lose them, I'll go back in and add more during the process.
Okay.
But what I do is, I think we've talked about this, we might have shown you before, but I make a wash.
Okay, so that's that burgundy.
Yeah, this is the burgundy. I was going to do a red. So you can kind of see it's kind of red.
Yeah, when it thins out, it brings a lot more of that red out.
Yeah. So I'm going to make a wash. I'm going to kind of control where that goes with just the water on my brush. So you can kind of see the consistency. And I'll go back to the model. Zoom back. Just put it in places. I know there's going to be shadow, like underfoot.
Yep. Yeah, that's part of my problem too. It's hard for me to figure out where all that is supposed to go. That's kind of why it's a slow process, right? So as you keep going, you're slowly figuring out where everything goes and brighten it or darken it depending on what you see.
Well, because we did the kind of the zenithal, the priming, I did. Strong light source from up above, but it still gives you an idea. I mean, like, you know, her underneath here stays pretty dark, right? Even that's the dark primer showing through. And I kind of, that's what I like doing it, even though I'm thinking over it. It still kind of helps you think about where your shadows are going to be.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's nice, and the tone is nice and soft. It's not when it started going on. I was like, that's a little strong, but that's why you were really like working it around.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just many, many thin layers, basically.
Yeah.
So, do you focus on one area at a time, or do you kind of move around?
I let one area dry. And it'll be sort of blotchy because it's the wash. But I let one area dry, and then I'll come back in and I'll do another area. I'll come in here. So I just work around the miniature. And I'm gonna paint on top of this, right? So even if I put it on
right
the
on, yeah, exactly. You don't need to worry about. I painted over the clothing a little bit here and there too. We're just trying to make sure the skin is right.
And I know it's hard to see the variations on the camera, but you can kind of see where it's wet on the model.
Uh huh. So this is. This isn't creating a shadow, really. It's...
No, I'm putting in my shadows.
Oh, okay. So you're kind of blocking them in a way?
Yeah, and then I'll go back over in areas so they're not as strong.
Okay.
But I'm sort of just putting in those thin washes. And like I said, there's no, I mean, there's always, I have to go back and do this again, right? I mean, it's just a process, and you just kind of, you learn.
Okay, I think my base is 100% now. I'll go through and start that.
Yeah, and like, and if my base coat, like if I have a spot, I'll go back over. I'll take some of my base coat color.
Okay. All right. So.
And I just, you know, it's my mistakes. I even fix my mistakes, right? So. So I'll let you, I can let you catch up too.
Okay.
If you want.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get an idea.
I'll readjust my cue.
I had a friend just text me, must be watching. I had the music, I usually have a music track running in the background, it was too loud for most people. So he's like, turn down the music. It's like, okay. Yeah, that's why I'm trying to watch what you're doing, and so I can't have all that up there. So. So yeah, I haven't. Okay, I'm trying to figure out exactly like.
So
am I focusing more on where it meets the, all the cloth or?
I do a little bit, but I'm gonna go back and do lining for that too.
Okay.
But like. Kind of just where naturally where you're gonna have shadows, like in between her boobs and. Maybe under here where her hand's going to be, and then her face, her eyes, by her nose, and then under her fingers right here. And then if you flip her up.
I got you. Get that extra perspective to try to see. Well, I don't have to worry about it on her legs, really, do I?
No, because I'm going to paint, and we're going to make it darker with the cloth.
Dang it, I'm noticing spots I missed with the base coat. Just little spots, like the very tops of her fingers I didn't hit.
Yeah, and you can go back in. I mean, I do it too. I had missed a spot here on her. And some of that you can fix when you're going around your painting. So... So, yeah, so basically, when you get the shadows in, you can go back in and add more. Oh, I didn't get her here. Once you do that, we can start. I can kind of explain the layering process. It's hard because, like, I can't see yours, right? I can just see mine.
Right.
But, yeah, just let me know. I can turn this light off. So
it's fine. I'm trying to follow along as best I can.
Okay. Yeah. And, I mean, you don't, I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, right?
Right.
So, is when you do like the Twitch stream,
yeah.
Is there another camera on your workspace then too?
Yeah, there's one on the thing I'm holding in my hands, one on my face, and then one on the palette.
Okay, that's cool. So it's like, I don't see any of that, but I figure since you said you have all that stuff you're managing, and you do it for the Twitch, I don't know, that's all, like, magical to me.
That's okay. Yeah, I know you've got your tech expert in the other room.
Yeah. I was like, when I turned Skype on earlier, I was like, oh, why can't I hear you? And it's like, oh, because I was using Skype Preview, so...
Okay, then.
Because this isn't my computer, it's Jonathan's computer, so... Like, I don't want to touch anything to make it blow up. All right,
I think I know. I think I'm good.
Okay.
I think I'm good.
So, what we're going to do is, I work in layers mostly, but, you know, I do a lot of the stuff wet blending, and I know we've talked about this, but I'm just doing a refresher.
No, you're good. You treat me like an idiot. That's good.
Because you got your Twitch streamers and everything, and right?
Yeah, yeah.
So I work in layers, so I like to thin down my paint. So we made that base coat.
Right.
And what I'm going to do with that base coat I made is I'm going to probably make another one about the same color because my paint is drying up a little faster than normal. So I'm going to make that base coat again.
Okay, so that's that kind of... Okay. I have a little more left on my palette than you do, but I'll probably mix it again just to see. Most of the other practice than anything else.
Yeah. So I'm just mixing that warmer brown with that warmer skin tone. And then what I'm going to do is, to work in thin layers, I'm going to start adding more of, like, my flesh tone into that darker tone we made to start bringing up my colors. So...
Oh, so you're going to mix that into that. Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to mix this one into this one to make it lighter.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Into this darker colors. This is my skin tone. I know it's hard to see the skin tone, but the skin tone into the darker color to start to make a lighter color. And I'm going to work my way up with my highlights on the miniature, and I can kind of show you. And I'm going to achieve the smooth transitions by working in the thin layers.
Okay. Dang it, I added way too much red. it was not red enough, and then I grabbed a little bit of red, and it like exploded with red.
A little red goes a long way.
Yeah. Now I know less next time. Yeah. Nice. Well, I got back to the color we had before, so I'm just adding more of that white. I think I'm good. Just making sure it's nice and thin, and then you're pulling that out really thinned.
Yeah. So okay. I can actually show you, like, on the back of my hand, like, about how much paint I'm gonna have, because I know paint consistency and the amount of paint in your brush is a big deal for people.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even think about it until people asked. I'm like, oh yeah, that would make sense, right? Because it's all trial and error. And what works for me doesn't necessarily work for everybody.
Okay.
And let me use a darker color. So you can kind of see, like, let me use a mixture of this brown and this red so you can see it on my hand. But when I've got my wet palette, I've got the water that's in my brush, and I've got the paints. And so I'm just basically, you can see I start to run out of paint after a handful of brush strokes. So there's not really that much paint in my brush. It's not, you know, full of a whole bunch of paint like that, like you can see not that much, right? That's so much. So it's just
interesting.
Yeah, it's not much at all. And I think that's some of the trick to painting layering, and why layering can be frustrating is because you're not working with a lot of paint. So you have to keep going back for more paint and kind of working in the layers, right?
Well, and it's that immediate impatience of not seeing what you want to see right away.
Right. the more you work on it, the faster you'll get.
Cool.
So, I mean, and also you can work faster with the technique, but your transitions aren't going to be as smooth. So if you don't want to do 20 plus, you know, layers of paint to have a nice transition, you can do this for tabletop, but it won't look as smooth, right? Because
okay.
You maybe only have to use 10 layers to get where you need to go.
Okay.
So, and I know, like, Aaron does wet blending, and, like, I've taken classes with wet blending and stuff, and so I kind of combine a whole bunch of things into painting, but mostly it's layering.
Okay.
So, all right. So, I can kind of show you.
So you're just grabbing that color we just mixed and making sure it's nice and thin?
Yeah, and it's going to be a little bit more of that flesh tone into that base color, so you're going to have a step above. And remember that it's going to look darker on your palette, and then it's going to dry, and it's going to be drier. It's going to go on darker and appear lighter after it dries. That's
okay.
What I was trying to say. And it's going to take several layers for you to start to see the transition, right? So, also be patient with that.
Okay.
Because it takes a couple of layers. And I know you said that what happens is you get impatient with your layers drying. So actually what I do is I work around the miniature with layering. So, like, I'm going to start on her arm.
Okay.
And I'm going to work the paint on her arm. And it's going to look like crap when you first start.
Okay.
Like, it's not going to look good. It's going to be blotchy. It'll be okay. Because you're just putting those first initial layers on.
Okay.
And I kind of, while the paint is wet, I kind of work the paint around.
Okay, just to try it and trying to make it an even coat?
Kind of, just to move the paint, to kind of bring the paint around, right, so it covers the model. Yeah, and so it's more even. And kind of, I guess you would call it feathering.
Okay.
That first coat, kind of down and around. And at this point, this is when maybe I'll take some of my red color and I'll blend the two together. So it's a little bit of wet blending.
Oh, okay.
So for me, at this point, my paint is drying so fast because it's warm in my studio. So I can actually, working between layers, they dry pretty fast. So you can see this is my second layer.
Mm-hmm. Mine's drying pretty fast too, so I'm actually keeping up with you.
That's good. And it might be the lights too, sometimes. Also, I don't have the door open to my room, so there's not as much air movement. So we're just working with our arm.
Mm-hmm.
You can see what I'm going to do is I'm going to work this way over the whole model, but I think it's best to give you guys an idea. Here, I'll try
just on one area.
Just on one area, and then I can work around the miniature, and then I don't have to, I can work a little faster, right? But what I'm going to try to do while I'm working is I'm going to keep adding this mid-tone, this flesh color, into that color that I keep working on. I'm working lighter and lighter and lighter from that dark color.
Okay. Are there specific spots on the arm that you are going to want to make brighter?
Yes. Okay. So I'll point them out now. So we have just a kind of like a basic basic highlighting here. It's nothing super special, like object source lighting or anything. So with this, what I want to do with my highlights is I'm going to try to make the highlights here on her arm.
Okay, like on the shoulder. Okay.
Yeah, I'm working my colors more here. And then she's got a little bit of definition, so I'll try to leave a little bit of definition. You don't have to worry about it too much.
Okay.
She's not, like, super built or anything. And then I'm going to try to work on here, her forearm, and probably even it out a little bit more on the back of her arm. And I can kind of talk you through the models, so when I start to paint, you kind of have an idea. So I'm going to work up, obviously, on her chest. I'm going to work up, you know, to this point. And with the card art, I have got the card art. And the card art kind of focuses that highlight here. So focuses that highlight here on her breasts. And then on her face, I just saw a white spot down here.
Yeah, I know. I've been seeing them here and there, and I'm trying to try to cover it.
Actually, let me pull my miniature out of focus and up to my face real quick.
That's fine.
So I can get my brush in there. Because that kind of covers up the, whatever she's using, the breast pump or whatever.
Yep.
Kind of covers up the face. So it's hard to get in there. And you can leave that in shadow. Like, I'm not going to worry about that as far as details go.
Right, yeah, the left side of her face is completely in shadow, basically.
Right. If you wanted to go nuts with it, I would say leave that arm off. If you wanted to paint that side of her face, like if you wanted a nice, like, all that. But you really don't have to, because her face is covered up by it. And it's so small that it'll be okay. So with her face, I like to focus my highlights on her cheek, on her nose, and then more on her chin here, and then her tips of her fingers will get the highlights. Same thing, so with this arm, focus the highlight here. We're gonna work up, you know, to that, I've got that that blonde kind of color. And then on her butt, focus here, and then maybe a little bit here, but I probably won't take it up as far.
Okay.
And this one won't go up as far either with the highlights. And then here I'm going to try to focus her highlights more on her, the top of her thigh, and where the tights aren't. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint it like it's skin here, up to a certain color, up to a certain highlight. And then what we're going to do is I'll come back in and we'll paint the darker color of her, of like her tights. And then we'll do a glaze over. So it sort of looks like her skin is showing through the tights.
Right.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah, I'm kind of doing the same thing over again on all the other parts.
Yeah, and it's going to be multiple layers. Let's see if I can get closer.
I was just getting an idea of where to put everything, I think. Because I don't think of... I have a hard time thinking really organically about this.
Okay.
I have a hard time getting to the point I see already see in my head. I don't know. It's a weird clash. So I find it hard. So this is helping me a lot. But yeah, I'm seeing it already on her leg. I did her leg, and it's just slightly brighter.
Yeah. And you're going to start, I mean, then, so that's the idea, and that's what we're going to do up to, like, the bright color, right? So up to that yellowish, that highlight. It's the same idea of mixing up.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know why the paint on my palette's drying out really quick, too.
You use a wet palette, don't you?
Yeah, it's not, it's good, it's just, for some reason, maybe it's just because I don't know. Maybe it's just really dry in the house. I don't know. It doesn't feel that dry, though. Not sure.
You know, sometimes, I think it was, yeah, yesterday it was raining. And sometimes when it's raining, or it's right after it rains, and we just have so much humidity in the air, because it's Georgia. I mean, that's anywhere, right, that has humidity in the air, but there's, like, this right mixture of warmth and humidity in the air, and the paint doesn't want to dry. But it cooled off a little bit, so the paint actually isn't too bad.
Where do I focus on her face, or do I not worry about that yet?
So with her face, on her nose. Yeah, let me see if I can focus it. So you can see a little better. So on her nose, kind of, I leave this first layer, I kind of paint over almost all of her face. By around her eyes, I leave it darker because her eyes will be more in shadow. And like I got rid of my shadow and I didn't want to, so I'll go back with, it's also hard because I can't get super close to my model when it's on camera, but I'll go back and add in some of my shadow if I feel like I've lost it. So basically, I try to focus on her nose, on her cheek, under her eye,
okay,
like on her lip here. I try to blend it all together, and then on her chin. But right now, with this layer of skin, since it's the mid-tone, that's going to be like your main color. And some painters like to put down their mid-tone first and then add in their shadows and highlights. I start from a darker mid-tone. It's just how my brain functions.
Okay.
So.
How many layers of this or do I keep adding a little bit of that skin of that lighter color with each layer?
Yeah, with each layer you're gonna do. You want to go back. I mean, as long as you feel like your transitions are fairly good. So with each layer, you're gonna add a little bit more, and a little bit more of the mid-tone color, so that more of that skin tone color. And then once you get to that point, then you start with your next highlight color. And see, there goes my camera. I gotta turn it back on.
Yeah, it did the thing, huh?
It did the thing, yeah, because it gets warm. So, let me give it one sec.
That's a pity. I just use webcams. I don't have a fancy camera for it.
This is the camera I use to take pictures. If I wanted to use Jonathan's really fancy camera that we use, I have to get some kind of converter, and it's fairly expensive to get some kind of converter to do this, which is very strange. Okay, so it should be good now.
Okay.
So yeah, I mean, it's just what was that? Mm-hmm.
on her left leg, where do I focus on the color, or just on that one knee?
On her left?
Yeah.
So we paint it, you can kind of see how it's half painted.
Yep.
So here, focus some of that, go up to that mid-tone here on her knee, right there.
Okay.
And then here on the back of her leg.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, and I might do, it's harder to sit here, and since I can't be as close to the model as I would normally get.
Okay.
I might do a lot of layers to get everything smooth. But when I do the teaching and stuff like that, it's basically just to kind of get the idea down.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, no, this helps a lot.
Okay.
Kind of sad, too. No, go ahead.
It's okay. I was going to say, I try not to worry about just all the transitions and how smooth I can make it. Because that also probably gets incredibly boring for people, too.
Well, yeah, it's just the sheer amount of stuff.
Yeah.
I'm trying to go through, and I went back over, I added a little bit of this color to that red, and made it, and thinned it, and then I went over back on those shadows again, try to blend the two layers together a little more. So, I'm still building up the color.
Yeah, and that's the idea.
And just slowly get it more smooth as you go along.
Mm-hmm. Wants to come in the room.
Isn't that funny? They don't care about you, and then you leave, and they're like, where are you?
Yep, she's looking for me. Yes, I'm in here, Squeakers. It's okay. My poor, pathetic little kitty. That's me up. She's upset because normally she's under my desk.
Oh, I see.
So.
She hangs out with you while you paint?
Yes. Right now I have the oldest dog in here with me, so she's quiet. So you can kind of see how I've started to get that flesh tone, and some of the spots where I have a couple layers.
Okay.
And the other trick is to start working in smaller and smaller areas.
Okay.
So you've laid down, so you work up to that bass tone, but that whole time, you know, you're trying to focus those highlights. So when I put down another layer, stay on her arm. Now this needs a couple more layers of work, but once I get a nice even coat on her arm, I'll work in smaller and smaller. So when you do your Twitch streams, did you say you do them 3 days a week?
Yeah, I do them. No, right now they're Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Because sometimes I have to take off on the weekends.
Right.
So that's the only time I can guarantee to be on. But I'm usually on pretty much every day.
That's crazy. Do you find it helps you paint?
It does. Like, get
more done? Yeah.
That's the biggest thing for me is otherwise I get distracted and... I don't know, it works out. I'm able to stay on, like, Twitch, the chat, and people ask me questions, and keeping interactive with people just keeps me... Oh. Well, looks like I'm gonna have to, that's one of the other things, though, too, is now I'm beholden to people, so I didn't turn on the free, like, you earn rewards per minute, so I'm gonna have to give people... So, people are texting... A friend of mine who's watching sent me another message. Hey, the thing's not on. It's like, dang it. That's the problem is I can't have both windows open to see chat. So I gotta focus on this. It's okay.
Well, you kind of know what's going on, so.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing is then it takes enough of my attention normally to where it's a good thing. But when I'm trying to figure out what's going on here, I literally just can't. I can't split my attention three ways. I'm a dude, I can't multitask.
Is it raining there?
No.
Is that what I...
No, somebody subscribed to me on YouTube.
Oh, I was like, what? Why did it sound like it was like thunder?
No. It's going to take me like 10 minutes to catch up with chat once I get on.
Well, I was going to say this reports for you, doesn't it? So you can always go back and watch it too.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't... I wanted to ask you though. I usually... I leave it on the VODs for Twitch for a while, but do you want me to make this, like, cut this together and make it for your Patreon page or something? Like,
oh no, you don't have to. I don't want to make more work for you. If you just leave it on your, you can just leave it on whatever you do.
Okay, that's cool. Fine.
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't know because this is this is directly related to what you guys do on Patreon, so I figured. Figured you'd want, like, I don't know. Then again, they'd be watching me do something, so that's not very, you know, not very professional. Yeah. It's better that everybody watches you than watching me.
You mean I'm not, not streaming with you?
No, so as in if you were to post this on your Patreon, it's not up to the same level that you guys do.
Oh, I thought the pressure was off of me. I'm like, wait. Are you just watching and you're the one streaming, or I'm streaming too?
I secretly installed a special software on your computer, so anytime you use it,
no. I meant right now. I didn't know if you had a window open with both of us painting or how it worked.
Yeah, no, so everybody's, I'm, my most, like 90% of the screen is covered by what I'm painting, but you're in the top left, so that, okay. Whatever the camera is showing. It's on a bit of a delay, though, so it's weird.
Because I thought I like, might have gotten out of all the pressure of doing a Twitch stream and be like, oh, well, if I'm just here, but I'm, like, a ghost.
Nope. You have some responsibility.
Right.
I know. I was really disappointed I couldn't get into any your classes when I was at Adepticon.
Yeah, they sold out within the first, like, 20 minutes, so I think a lot of people's did.
Classes I took were good, though.
Yeah, what did you end up taking?
I took three classes with Angel, which were really good, but airbrush specific. Then I took a class with Matt Sexwish, took one with Aaron, which was good, and then two with Kirill. But like I said, that gap, that knowledge gap, like half of Kirill's class was theory. And then the rest, yes. Like it helped me think of painting stuff, because we did one on cloth, and then one on metals, and thinking of it was interesting, the way he thinks about it. But I mean, that after that class, I'm not nearly close to, you know, what the crazy realistic stuff he does.
I know his stuff is nuts.
Yeah, I mean, you could do it. I saw the one he submitted for Crystal Rush. It's like you could just. It's like he went back in time, chopped a guy in half, shrank him, froze him, and brought him back.
Yeah.
Sorry, that went really morbid really quick. Now we know his secrets. He secretly goes back in time, kills people, and freezes them and brings them back and enters them in competitions.
Secrets out, Carol. We all know.
Well,
murderer.
He's Russian, right? So, I mean, it's not beyond them. Some secret Soviet, some secret old Soviet program that he stumbled upon.
Yep.
All right,
he's
so.
Quiet.
Yeah, I know. Explains it all. So, how high do I make, like, I don't know where to, like, I don't know. I guess I'm at the point where I don't quite know what to do, or at least I'm not knowing where to put the brighter tone.
So, I'm working up, I work up until I feel like I've gotten that mid-tone, which I'm almost there with some of her.
Okay.
And what we can do is I can just show you, like, on parts of her, like, where we go from there.
Okay.
Kind of speed up the process. Like, on her, I've got her thigh. Because, like I said, it's a long process for me too. Even just doing.
So do I just add, just keep adding white color, and that's, or that brighter skin tone?
So yeah, I'm just working up to that brighter skin tone until I get to a point where I feel that I've gotten as far as I can with that color.
Okay.
And then I switch to my next highlight color, which, give me 1 second, and let me work up in a couple places to that color.
Okay. No, you're fine. I'm just... I also don't know where to... I don't know where we're going with the shadows, either. We've got 15 minutes, I think, but...
Yeah, well, the shadows are mostly in.
Oh, okay.
I go back and maybe add a little bit if I've lost some of it. But that's why I work up from my, I work up to a brighter color, because I'm leaving in my shadows, right?
Mm-hmm. So I'm picking out the fingers now, making them quite a bit brighter. Just to give them some definition, because they're not very obvious most of the time.
And I was gonna say I haven't done her fingers either.
No, that's fine. I swear everybody wants to call me when I'm on stream. Every time.
You know you're busy.
Yep. It's like they have all morning, and then they'll leave me a message. I'll call them back tomorrow. It's all good. So that brighter, that next brighter color, is it just a mix with a little of that yellow, or even just
I'm actually going to make it easy, and I'm just going to go up with the Joe Sonia, the Naples yellow.
Okay.
Which is, we can just make it, keep it simple, and, you know, use the three colors, three or four colors.
Okay.
And get this done. So. It's a very light color. And I try to put it next to that tone you were working up to. Try to put it next to that one on your palette so you can mix the two together, because you're going to mix up into that yellow.
Okay, well, I still have kind of my pools of... The skin tone I've been using is kind of dry now.
Okay.
So.
Then, you probably don't want to work with dry paint, so just throw some more back onto your palette. Like start a new little area of paint.
No.
You work with a wet palette, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, it actually should be fine. No, it's fine. It was almost to that point, but not quite. Because I've been making it a little brighter with a little bit more skin tone. So.
Yeah.
Oh, dang it! I did the red thing again. Yep. Cool. I almost messed it up.
And so. To show you this color so you kind of have an idea against my skin. It's light. It's really light,
yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Oops.
So we're going to be doing the same thing that we did before, but working in smaller and smaller areas.
Okay.
So, like, I can focus on some of the areas that I built up already. I don't feel like I've built up as much as I want to. For sake of showing you.
Cool. I'm trying to mix. How much of that yellow do I mix in?
Just a little bit to start off with.
Okay, and then it's like the skin tone, and I add more and more.
Yeah. Here. Okay, so you can kind of see my palette.
Yeah.
So, when I start mixing in, I have this skin tone here, and I'm just gonna mix in. Start by mixing in just a little bit to make an in-between, right? And then work up. And then take this and kind of work into here until I'm only working with this color.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, that makes sense. Cool.
Yeah.
I had to kind of mix the skin tone, so I'm kind of using it now as just a lighter version, I guess, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm hoping I don't mess up completely.
Alright,
I'm gonna take a little, I'm gonna make sure it's really thinned, and then that way, worst case, I can kind of blend it.
Okay.
Before I go too crazy. All right. No, it's good. I just need to make sure I don't apply too much all at once.
Yeah, go really light.
Oh, nice. That is a really nice transition, actually.
Mm-hmm.
It's not too much, not too little. That's great. So...
Yeah, it's good for warmer skin tones, as the yellow is, to go up highlight.
Interesting. Never would have thought. Huh, cool.
So you can kind of see, I don't know how... When I turn the light off, it makes it a little darker. So you can kind of see the transition.
Sorry, the sound is a lot of, is people following the Twitch channel.
Oh no, it's fine. It is completely fine.
And there they go. And I want to say thank you for everybody who's following, but I've got to make sure that I don't talk over you, Liz.
No, it's okay.
Alright, yeah, I made it. Okay, I made it. Dang it. I have to go back down. I made her arm much lighter than I should have.
Yeah, and so if you do that, if you make a mistake, it's simply just go back in with the paint, that paint you were using, like even with some of the darker paint, and kind of throw it in there, right? So, like I just threw my shadow back in there, and that's what I was talking about, where it's all just this mix.
Mm-hmm. I've got you. Okay. Yeah, this is interesting. Yeah. Okay. I need to work a little thinner. I'm probably going to take some of that paint I've been using and add it to another little section. There we go. Then I can kind of pull it the spots I want. Interesting. Yeah, this is the one I'm definitely going to save and go back over myself, because...
Mm-hmm. And you can even start on, like, with mine, you can start to see the transition, right?
Oops.
Like, now when you put that highlight in there, you can start to really see it.
Yeah. Zoom in on the area I've got here. Yeah, I know one of another Twitch streamer just hosted me, which is very nice of him. But it's sad because I'm sure he's messaged me in the chat and I can't message him back right now.
If you want to, I'm just doing the layers. I mean, if you wanna. You know, step away for a second and do some admin stuff.
It's fine. We've only got a couple minutes left anyway. I just want to make sure that I at least say something and I don't completely neglect everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Actually, I was saving this. I totally forgot to use it for when you came on. I wanted to do this. I want to see if it's still up. Yeah, so, yeah, yes. This is Liz. Make sure you... give her a warm welcome.
Hi, everybody.
I pulled up an applause track for our first guest appearance. Oh, this is actually really good. Thank you for having the time.
Oh, yeah, it's no problem. What was I going to say? Oh, so I was going to say that, so you can kind of see with her face.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how well it's reading. Let me move it down a little bit. So you can kind of see how I've left this darker.
Right, just right under her hair.
Yeah, I'm working my highlight here. Because this would be catching the light, and this would sort of be in shadow, because of her hair, right? So,
okay.
And same thing with under here. So this is sort of more in a little bit of shadow. Excuse me. and here would catch most of the light. And obviously, it, you know, the miniature is meant to have a big boobs, so that you know, they're kind of the focal point. But I might bring this up just a little bit.
Okay. But
for the most part, I'm gonna leave that in shadow. And I've used some of that burgundy wine. That's my...
Just added a little bit.
Yeah, you can go back in and kind of add that shadow, because her hand would cast a little bit of a shadow.
Yeah, I've just been purposefully not painting that, and leaving a lot of that shadow in there in the first place.
Yeah.
If that makes any sense.
Oh, it does. I'm just playing with her. I'm just playing with the face.
Gotcha. You're just making sure that the face has some pretty decent shadows.
Yeah, and the transitions are good, because the transitions were a little wonky. She had some weird lines, which you have to be careful, you know, with your transitions. Especially with female faces, they're so much softer.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I don't do much makeup. But if I do, I mean, she kind of, in the art, she kind of has pink lips. So what I might do is, my hands are really shaky right now.
Are you just holding it in an angle you don't normally hold it?
Yeah. And normally, I mean, I wouldn't be sitting it on my desk. I'd be holding it back, you know, back more. And I actually don't rest my hands on anything. Well, I think I rest my hands on my desk. Let me sit naturally. Okay, so I don't really rest my arms when I paint. I'm just holding the miniature on the fob and painting. And I might rest my elbow on the arm of my chair, but it's just a weird angle.
Okay.
So, do some of her butt with that highlight.
So I just mix a little bit more yellow in if I'm going higher?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, like, I'm doing that right now. I'm just taking right from that yellow. And I'm putting it on just the top of her shoulder here. Oh, and there goes my camera.
Yep.
That's okay.
It just decided to shut off.
Again, yeah, it's the safety feature.
Yeah, I missed right under her boobs. I missed the shadow completely. Like, not completely. I think I did it the first time, but now it's just not quite. Like, it's not even close to where it needs to be.
Oh no!
So it's just, I've got to go back in and make sure.
That's the most important part too.
Yep. Well, no, it's just because the way I've been holding it, I haven't noticed.
No, I know.
Yeah.
I'm just being silly.
No, it's okay. No, I might. You could tell me anything, and I probably believe it, just because I'm focused. I'm like, turn off everything you know, so that you get this right, and then so you could just tell me things, and I'd be like, oh, okay. All right. I gotta try to replicate that main tone again. Probably blend it with a little bit of that shadow, just to...
And I can send you a picture afterwards if you want. That'll probably be more evenly modulated, like the color itself, because it won't be on my desk, right? Or my camera will take better photos and, you know.
Right.
So if you want to match that, I can take a picture of my palette for you as well.
Cool.
So
I can put it in the video. This is what it's supposed to look like.
Yeah. And I can send you a picture of the work in progress if you want to.
Cool. And then like I said, it's okay. We can do it on stream next time or not. That's totally up to you.
Yeah, and it's fine. If you want to do a little bit more.
I forget, is it a half hour each month, mm-hmm. or was it a full hour? It's a full hour each month, right?
It's a full hour, yeah.
I don't even know where we are now. I think we did that one long session the first time, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we did.
So I don't know where we're at.
Yeah, and it's hard. I mean, it's hard for me. Like, if you want to do something next week or the week after, I've got some time before I go to San Diego. It's just hard because it's hard to sit down for more than an hour, and especially having to paint, right, like, on a camera.
Right.
And sitting here, and I'm just like, oh, I don't know how you do it. You're crazy.
Yep. I'm definitely that.
Plus, I also have to film one of our Patreon videos, so.
What are you working on?
We have to do the video. Aaron put his videos up, and now we have to do our video for this last month. We're just a couple days behind, so.
Okay.
The faces.
Oh, so you're doing, is he doing male faces, or you're doing female ones? Or?
I'm doing female faces, yeah.
Cool.
So that's what I'll be doing after I get off the stream with you. And I usually write up, I need to watch his videos so I don't.
Do the same thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
I know we both do stuff differently, but, you know. That's normally how I like to do it, so.
Yeah. Just blending. Blending this is, I don't know, I've, just this one session, I've learned a ton more about skin tones than I knew before.
Oh, well, that's good. Because I think, no, we didn't do skin tones or anything, we just did, we did that 40K guy.
Yep. Which was basically just layering.
Yeah.
Maybe a little highlighting, but there wasn't too much to it.
Alright. So, I will probably call it here. So,
okay.
We basically got to some parts where I kind of showed the different transitions. Well, like you can see on her leg and on her arm,
mm-hmm.
are pretty good up to that yellow, and you can almost start to see that yellow. And again, it's just how many layers you want to do. So.
Yeah, no, that's pretty good.
Yeah. So.
Cool.
All right. So. You can put her in frame. I don't know if you want this view. Of Miss Wet Nurse. Looking all fancy there.
Oops. Trying to move the window so that I can zoom in on your work, but I moved to the other one. Yeah, pretty good. Kind of pulled them together. Yeah.
Yeah, and she's kind of washed out. Like I said, I can take a photo for you.
No, that's so okay. Cool. All
right.
Awesome.
All right.
Thank you very much, Liz.
Oh. Yes.
Just let me know about a time next week.
Sure, sounds good.
We'll figure it out. Cool.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
All right, give me a second and I'll come back on chat. Oh. Make sure that's on. Sorry. Here I am. Hey, I'm here. I'm back, kind of. 50 million people. Wow. Yes, 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 very much so, Imperial Torches. Good job. Yes, Liz should stream, but she's got anxiety about it. It's funny almost. So, yeah, there. That was some pretty good progress for just an hour, and a lot better than I think I would have done myself. So, that's awesome. All right, I'm gonna take just a short, like, couple minute break, and then I'm gonna come back. I gotta actually finish Percival. So, she's there. Yeah, because I've got her and her sister to finish. And I'm honestly not sure. I think I'm going to do them both in True Metallic instead of Non-Metallic. Just because the Non-Metallic is just... it's not quite right, if that makes any sense. So, it gives you some idea from... it was a stream last week that I did it. Yes, I must destroy the break... destroy. Deploy, yes. I don't have it in here, so I'll go grab it really quick. And I can actually put it in a window where you can actually see it. I will be back. Alright, here's the panda to keep everybody company. There he is. There, I'll even go. There he is. Alright, I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. Besides, the panda stopped dancing. That's darn. That's dumb. I guess there wasn't enough light for him. He's a little solar guy. He's normally fine, but I guess I don't have my lights on bright enough. Alright. Uncover the palette. I'll work in it. I am purposefully not responding to that, Gonazol. Nope. Alright. I'm a little too dark. I'm gonna turn that up a little bit. Give me a second. Sorry, my thoughts. Where are my thoughts? There we go. Let's brighten that up a bit. Still look like a ghost, but there I am. Okay, and I couldn't find an image of Percival, but I think I should be fine. So I'm going to just put her in the corner. She looks great. Ah, so psyched about that.